Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss the previous year questions from the chapter Timber from GATE, ESE, State PSC exams, ISRO exams, etc. Let's see them one by one. The first question is, which one of the following is the hardest wood? It is a very basic question. The answer is sesame. Sesame is the hardest wood among babul, chir, teak and shisham. Shisham is the hardest wood. Next one is, woodwork may be measured nearest to. It is an important question. First option, 0.001, 0.002 meter, 0.003 meter, 0.004 meter. That is it 1 mm, 2 mm, 3 mm or 4 mm? Let's go to explanation of this question. According to IS 1200 Part 21 1973, if length or width is to be measured, it is measured to a nearest of 0.01 mm. If it is a length or breadth, it should be measured up to 0.01 mm. If it is area, it should be 0.01 meter square. If it is volume, it should be nearest to 0.01 m cube. So for length, breadth, area, volume, whatever, maybe the numerical value is to be nearest to 0.01. But in woodwork, we are actually measuring the thickness of the particular section. So if we are going for making a door, we will see the thickness. That is what is called the measuring of the woodwork. So we will consider the thickness, and according to IS 1200, the thickness have to be measured nearest to 2 mm. So our answer is 2 mm. The woodwork should be measured nearest to 2 mm. Let's see the next question. This question is a previous year from SSCGE 2007. Seasoning of timber is done for removing knots from the timber, sap from the timber, roughness of the timber, none of this. We know that knots from the timber can be removed by cutting or converting processes. Next option is sap from the timber. We know it is the right answer, sap from the timber. Next question. The disease of dry rot is caused by. The disease of dry rot is caused by complete submergence in water, alternate wet and dry processes, lack of ventilation, none of this. It is not submergence in water, because when we are submerging timber to water, it will cause a certain water stains and also later leads to fungi attack. Next is alternate wet and dry condition. It is the reason behind wet rot, not dry rot. It is the reason behind wet rot. Next one is lack of ventilation. Obviously, this is the right one. Dry rot means the wood will change to form of a powder. I have already said that this is basically causing in moist condition where there is a lack of sunlight and lack of proper ventilation. Next one is age of a tree is understood by. This is a very important question. In early 2000s, that means up to 2012 and all, SSCJE had repeated this question many times in the exam. Nowadays, it is not that as in an SSC exam. Still, it is a very important question. The age of the tree is understood by measuring the diameter of the pitch, thickness of the bark. We know the age is measured by using the annular rings. Age of the trees are measured by the annular rings. Next is the next question. Generally, the wooden molds are made from. So, the wooden molds are made from We know it's not plywood. Next one is sesame wood. Next is deodar wood. Next is teak wood. In the later part of this video, we will see the use of different types of wood. Here, the answer is for the wooden molds, we have to use sesame wood. Next question, please excuse that question. It came in between. Good quality sandals never obtained from. The question is, good quality sandals never obtained from. We know from earlier ages, we were collecting river sand for the purpose. So it should be of good quality from. The answer here is C. We will discuss this topic in the chapter of aggregates. The good quality sand is never obtained from the sea. Next question is, plywood is made from. Options are common timber, bamboo fiber, teak wood, only ascot or sheet. So the answer here is from common timber. Plywood is obtained from common timber. Next question. Seasoning is a process of removing sap, creosoting, painting and sodium silicate, coating with tar. We know that seasoning is the process of removing the sap from the timber. Next is a layer of dry bricks. Sorry, this was a question I missed in bricks, so I am including that question here. Two such questions are there in this video. A layer of dry rot put below the foundation in case of soft soil is called as, it is called as soiling. Shoring means we are given temporary supports to a damaged structure. That is what is called as shoring. DPC and all we will discuss in the other chapters. Next question is, hollow bricks are generally used with the purpose of reducing the cost of construction. No, it's not the answer. Providing insulation against heat, that can be the answer. Let's see all the options. Increasing the bearing area and also the ornamental work. Not all these are the answers. So the answer should be providing insulation against heat. Back to timber questions again. The life of the teak wood doors and windows are usually taken to be 80 years, 60 years, 40 years, 20 years. The answer is 40 years. This is a basic question. The answer is 40 years life of teak wood doors and windows. We are using teak for the furniture doors and windows because it have a large lifespan, and also it is commercially very important timber. Let's see the next question. According to the IS code, the weight of the timber is reckoned at a moisture content of. We know the answer, it is 12%. The expansion and shrinkage of plywoods are comparatively low as So what is the reason for the low shrinkage and expansion of the plywoods? They are held in position by adhesives. Actually, it is a right point. They are held in position by adhesives. They are glued under pressure. Yes, they are glued under a pressure of 7 to 14 kilogram per centimeter square. The piles are placed at right angles to each other. They are prepared from Venus. Actually, all the four answers are correct. But the correct or the perfect answer is that they are placed, or the Venus are placed at right angles to each other. That gives the more stability and more strength to plywood. So the option is the piles are placed at right angles to each other. Let's see. Let's match the following question. A deciduous trees. Deciduous trees are actually, let's see the ABCD. Deciduous, conifer, endogenous, exogenous. Next list is softwood, hardwood, eucalypts, bamboo. So we know that Deciduous are actually, they are hard wood. Conifers are basically soft wood. Endogenous trees, example is eucalyptus. Endogenous tree example is bamboo. Exogenous tree example is eucalyptus. So we have matched A2, B1, C4 and D3. That is the answer for this question. Next one is, during the conversion of the timber by sawing, in order to obtain strong timber pieces, the cut should be made by ordinary sawing, tangential sawing, quarter sawing and radial sawing. We have seen the explanation of this question in the previous video. If anyone is there who haven't watched the chapter or the theory videos of timber, please do watch the videos. During the conversion process, which one of the following type of sawing will give the strongest one? The ordinary sawing, we know it's not the ordinary sawing. Tangential, not the tangential. Quarter, it's a radial sawing. We know the reason also. In radial sawing, we will be cutting that in radial direction of the annular rings. If it is the annular rings, we will cut the pieces in a radial direction. So we are getting the medullary rays we are getting to hold the annular rings together. So that makes the particular section more strong. So the option is radial sawing. Next one is another match the following question. I have been given the list of two here and I think we can answer from the first lids itself. The innermost part or the core of the stem of a tree is called. We know the answer, that is the pith is the innermost part or the core. Vascular tissue which encloses the pith. So first one is we have the pith. Surrounding to that there is heartwood. Surrounding to that there is sapwood. Surrounding to that there is cambium layer. Then the bark can be inner bark and outer bark. So next question is the vascular tissue which encloses the pith, that is the heartwood. So that is the heartwood. Next one is the cellular tissue and the woody fiber arranged in distinct concentric rings are called. It is the annular rings are arranged as concentric circles. The thin layer below the bark not converted to sapwood yet is called as the cambium. We know that cambium is yet to be converted into sapwood. Next is, the strength of timber is maximum in the direction perpendicular to the grain, parallel to the grains, 45 degree to the grains at all angles. We know the answer, it is parallel to the grains. If we are applying the load along parallel direction to the grain, we will get the maximum strength for the timber. The ratio of tangential shrinkage to the radial shrinkage of wood due to reduction in the moisture content is in the range of 3.1 to 5.1, in the range of 2 to 3, in the range of 1 to 2, it is less than or equal to 1. The option correct option is in the range of 3.1 to 5.1. I don't get the explanation for this video. If I am getting any explanation textbook or from the IS code, I will give you the explanation later. Next question is, consider the following methods of reservation of timber. Pressure application, brush application, dipping, open tank application. So correct sequence of these methods in the order of their effectiveness, in the order of their increasing order of their effectiveness. So we know that the brush application will give the least effect, so 2. Then it will be dipping. This is actually a common sense question. Next one will be open tank treatment, in which we are dipping or the timber in an open tank full of preservatives. So it will be 4, and the last and the most effective one will be application by usage of pressure. So 2, 3, 4, 1, the option is C. Next question, the timber preservative Creosote belongs to the group of. We know that creosote is formed by the distillation of coal or some vegetative matter. So it is actually a tar oil type. Next question. As a natural material, the timber belongs to which of the following? It is isotropic, anisotropic, homogeneous or heterogeneous. So we have seen in the properties of timber that timber is an anisotropic material, since in different direction we are getting different properties, that is different E values, different specific gravity, different mass gravity, T on different directions properties changes, so it is an anisotropic material. Next one is again a match of following question. Heart shake, knot, rod, sapwood. List 2. Disintegration caused by fungi. Outer layers of a log of a wood, a branch base embedded in timber by natural growth, cracks which are widest at the center and diminishing towards the outer circumferences. So let's match. A means hardwood. We know that it is the cracks that are formed from the inner part or the width and then extending towards the outer circumferences. So for A, the option will be 4. Next one is knots. Knots, we know that it is the left out portion of some broken branch. So it is 3. Next one is rot. Rot, we know that there are sweat rot, dry rot, sap rot, like that. All these are caused by the attack of fungi. So the option is disintegration caused by fungi, that is 1. Next one is sapwood. Sapwood is the outer layers of a log of a wood. So 2. The option is 4, 3, 1, 2. Next one is the shear strength of the timber is depends upon which of the following? Lignin with fibers, medullary reeds, heartwood, sapwood. We know it cannot be sapwood and heartwood. Then option is medullary ray, but it is not the medullary ray, since the function of the medullary rays is to hold the annular rings together. So the final option left is shear strength is caused by the lignin with the fibers. Lignin between the fibers causing them or holding the fibers together. So it is the lignin with the fibers. Next is seasoning of timber will result in increased strength, increased durability, reduced resilience and increased dimensional stability. So let's see from the options we have to choose. Increased strength, obviously it is answer. Increased durability, yes. Reduced resilience, no, it cannot lead to reduction in the resilience. This resilience and resilience rigidity term actually comes in the strength of material chapters. So we will cover that subject soon. Then we will get to know what is exactly this resilience means. I am not explaining in a short way here. Next option is increased dimensional stability. Obviously this can be happen. The seasoning, increased strength, increased durability, increased dimensional stability. So the option is 1, 2 and for option A. Next, see the next question. Timber can be made reasonably fire resistant by. We know that fire resistant can be done by Abel's process and also by tarring processes. So let's see option. Soaking it in ammonium sulfate. Actually it can be, but it don't say the exact one. Ammonium sulfate plus borax. Borax is needed for the Abel's process, so that cannot be the answer. Next one is coating with tar paint. Obviously that is the answer. Next one is crotal oil into the timber under high pressure. Actually it increases the durability of the timber. Seasoning process, no, seasoning process is not for fire resisting properties. Which of the following statements are true? Knots in a tree affect the continuity of the fiber. Obviously knots in the tree will lead to a discontinuity of fibers, yes, in the timber, and also it becomes a point of weakness. So it is a correct one. Nail knots not influence the strength of the timber. That is the right answer. Because of this, we are creating so much of nail knots in the different parts of timber, and also nails are used for connecting different timber pieces. So it don't affect the strength of the timber. It is true. Dexterous of the wood is not a defect. Actually, it is a defect that is caused by the natural forces. It will lead to formation of yellow or white powdery patches in the wood. So it is a wrong option. Tall trees with the twisted fibers can we use give good timber for poles. It is right one. We have seen that the twisted fibers will give good compression members. So it is the right answer. So 1, 2, 4 are the options. So the option is B. Next question. The maximum deflection in the timber beams or the joists should not be greater than. The maximum deflection in the timber beams or the joists should not be not greater than. That is the span by 360. Actually, there is a explanation from the IS code. In timber beams, the maximum deflection specified is span by 350 when the beam supports some brittle coverings like asbestos sheet, earthen wire, slates, gypsum, etc. Otherwise, the deflection is limited to span by 240. In case of cantilever, it is somewhat more. The deflection not exceeds span by 180. Next one is, wood is impregnated with chrysotile oil in order to change in color. No, chrysotile oil not give color. Solignum paints gives color. So it is not the answer. Protecting against fungi, it can be the answer. Protecting the annular layers, no, it cannot be. Fill up the force. So the option is protect against fungi. Next one is, in tree, the cambium layer is situated between. We know that the cambium layer is between the bark and the sapwood, or more specifically, it is between the inner bark and the sapwood. So the option is B. Option B, that is the inner bark and the sapwood. Next is a list. One is given, list two is given. List one gives the name of different trees, and list two is their usage. So babble. Before going to that question, we will see the next slide for the usage of different types of timber. Babble is actually used for agricultural instruments. Bentik is used for board and furniture. Deodar is more cheap, rough furniture. It's so that it can be used for packaging boxes and sleepers, etc. Then mulberry. Mulberry is used for sports wood. Oak is also used for sports wood. Sal is used for ship and sleepers. Palm is used for as rafters. Jack tree timber is used for the musical instrument. Sesam is mainly used for decorative purposes. So let's back into the question. So babble is used for agricultural tools. For agricultural tools, we will use babble. Bentik is used for yash furniture, board and furniture. So furniture. Bija sal, that I think it is the sal itself. Sal is actually used for ships and sleepers. So it is bija sal, means it's a sal that is bought. Then mulberry. Mulberry, it is used for sports wood, that is tennis rack. So this is the answer. Babble as agricultural tools, bentik as furniture, bija sal as the for the board, and mulberry for the tennis rackets. Next one, which of the following treatment is used for fire resistance? Askew treatment, Edel's process, creosoting, and tarring. Tarring is the answer. Let's see the next question. Advantage in using the plywood is that the tensile strength is equal in all directions. Higher tensile strength in longer direction, higher tensile strength in shorter direction, lower tensile strength in longer direction. So we can cancel the last two. It means the same thing. We know that if the veneers are placed right angles to the each other based on their fibers, so it will give same strength in all direction, that is same tensile strength in equal direction. Next question. In respect of the moisture content in the wool, the fiber saturation point which refers to which of the one? Free water present in the cell? No, at the fiber saturation point, no free water is present in the cavities. Free water present in the cell walls and the cell cavities? No, in the cell cavities the water will evaporate. No moisture present in the cell walls and the cell cavities? No, it is not like that. Blank's option is no free water exists in the cell cavities, but the cell walls are saturated. So that's the correct point. At the fiber saturation point, the cell cavities get emptied by water, but this water will still present in the cell walls. Next one, which is the IS code used for the classification of timber for seasoning purposes? It is IS 1141. We have already seen that IS 1141. Next is the moisture content in a structural timber is about. Moisture content in the structural timber is about 12 to 15. So the best answer that suits here is only 10 to 20. So that is the answer. The moisture content in the structural timber should be 10 to 20. The peculiar curved swelling found in a body of a tree is called as burls, ringales, callus, abscess. Burls means we know that if there was an injury at the young age, there will be some uncontrolled growth in the timber that will lead to the formation of burls. Callus, we know when there is an injury or something, soft tissues will form around that injury. That tissue is called as the callus. Abscess is that it is the rupturing of the fiber due to some crushing or not properly felling the trees. So the answer here is the ringales. Some rounded projections that is seen in the body of a tree. Due to the attack of the rot, dry rot, the timber will. We know that dry rot is that the timber will get into powder. So it leads to the cracks. No, it is not leading to the crack. Mostly the fungi attack not lead to the cracking. Cracks are mainly formed during the seasoning process. Twist is also during seasoning process. Next one is shrink. It can be the answer. Next, the timber hardens. Obviously, it is a defect that won't lead to the hardness of the timber. So the option will be shrinks. This was not a direct question. Still, from the option, we can find the answer. That is the peculiarity of this question. Next is, age of the tree can be ascertained by radius of the stem? No. Circumference of the stem? No. Number of branches? No. Number of annular rings? Correct answer is number of annular rings. We know the answer. Each year, new annular rings will be formed. Which one of the defect in the timber is due to the natural forces? We are already done with all the kind of defects due to the fungi, defects due to natural forces, defect during the process of conversion, defect during seasoning. So if anyone is there who haven't seen any of the video, please go back to the playlist and watch the videos. There are 3 videos which covers every topic in timber. So let's see the options. Knot, stain, split and bow. So we know that knot is the answer. Knot is the part of the broken branches that is left behind in the timber. Stain is, we know, stain, all type of stains are caused by fungi. Split and bow are actually structural changes that are caused during the heating or the seasoning process. Which of the following statement is correct? Seasoning of timber increases the strength. Obviously, that is a correct term. Seasoning of timber increases the life. Yes, seasoning is increases the durability. Seasoning of timber result in the dimensional instability. Actually, seasoning of timber will lead to the dimensional stability. So, this one is the not correct one. Seasoning of timber reduces the weight. Yeah, sometimes seasoning of timber will reduces their density, that leads to the reduction in their weight. Next one is, which among the following can be used as a method for seasoning for the removal of sap from the timber? So we know that seasoning is obviously the process of removal of sap from the timber. Hot open tank treatment. No, cresorting. This is actually the process of application of preservative. Hot and cold open tank treatment means that, and in open tanks we are pouring the preservatives and the timber is put into that open tank either in a cold condition or in a hot condition. This is what is known as hot and cold tank treatment. So it is for the application of the preservatives. Next one is cresorting. Cresorting is actually the application of cresort oil at a high pressure. Next one is boiling. Yes, boiling can be a method of seasoning. Next one is Sarah Bale's process. We know that it is for the fire resistance purpose. It is actually a preservation process. So boiling is the correct one. So boiling in water seasoning is there. We know that water seasoning is there. So many kinds of seasoning is there. Where sometimes so we will put the timber in a highly boiled water and later on we will make them for air drying. So boiling is a seasoning process here. Rest of the others are process of preservation of timber. Next one is, in the cross section of a timber, the cambium layer can be occurred in. This is a repeated question. It is between the inner bark and the sapwood. Next one, ask you a preservative of the wood developed by the Forest Research Institute, Dehradun, comprises of the chemical arsenic pentoxide, copper sulfate, and potassium permanganate in the proportion of. We know it is 1:3:4. We have seen in the video. Next question. It is also a similar question. The age of the log of the timber can be estimated by the number of annular rings. This question is very important, so that it is coming repeatedly in so many exams. Timber can be made seasonally fire resisting by soaking in the ammonium sulfate, coating with coal tar. Pumping, we have seen this question. It is coating with the coal tar. That means this same question have repeated 2 times in different exams. The radial split in the timber originating from the bark and the narrowing towards the pith is called as heart shakes, star shake, cup shake, and knots. We know the answer. It is the star shake. Star shake, that is originating from the bark and going towards the pith. So star shake is the answer. Cup shake means there will be separation of fibers in the annular rings. Knots, we know that it is formed. So it's a defect due to broken branches. Next one is, the compressive strength of a structural timber is minimum in a direction of. The question is that minimum, we know the maximum, it is parallel to the maximum is parallel to the direction of the grain. So the minimum will be obviously perpendicular to the direction of the grains. The moisture content in a properly seasoned timber is in the range of. Properly seasoned timber, we know it is 5 to 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12, 12 to 15. It is 10 to 12 percentage. So here is the end of the video. In this video, we have discussed all the previous year questions that I can collect from. The next chapter we will be covering in the building materials will be stone. If anyone like this video, please subscribe to my channel, that is Civil Engineering Classes. In this channel I will be covering all the civil engineering subjects one by one and their previous year questions. So the next chapter will be stone. Thank you.